time for The Match Game, Hollywood Square, our Wiz from Happy Days, Anson Williams. From Mr. Smith, Leonard Fry. Sybil Danning. Bill Crocker. Jenny Lee Harrison. And the stars of The Match Game, Hollywood Square's Hour, Gene Raver and John Bowman.
Okay. Thank you.
They have released the animals. We welcome you with all our hearts, don't we?
We have met the animals, and they are ours.
Right, they are us.
Yes.
No. We appreciate your enthusiasm, but remember, it's an hour show. You got to save a little for later on. Right now, we need more of your... Well, listen, as long as you're here, is there... Can we do that? Is that why you're turning lights on?
Yeah, they're all lit now.
Yeah, look at that.
Listen,
well,
we might as well
say
something to them.
What's your name?
Should we sit in one slot?
Where are you from?
Rhode Island.
Rode Island. There's a bus leaving in 5 minutes. Thank you. All right, that's all I want to say. You're a wonderful, good-looking bunch, and thank you for coming.
Why have they lit them, though?
Because we referred to them, and they thought, Mark Breslow thought we were going to come out here and say hello, and we did.
Should we bring in makeup?
Yeah.
They're
yes.
looking...
Yeah. Right.
They look like they need a little help.
It's okay. Nice to have you here. Now, would you join John and me and say hello to our stars? Brisk round of applause here.
I'll check it out.
Hello,
see how
stars!
They do.
Applause! Thank you. How's your finger?
I'm going to grab the red light with my right hand.
Everybody ready?
We're ready.
Oh, yes.
We're ready to go.
Are you ready?
No, I'm not.
She's
I'm always
ready.
Ready, but not quite. I have something for you, Gene.
Oh, really?
Yes, I brought as a little souvenir a picture for your wallet.
Hmm? This is a picture for my wallet?
Yes.
Is it a fold-out?
Oh, it is a fold-out.
For his wallet or his wall?
Yes. For his wallet.
Oh,
there is
a just a picture, you know.
Whoa.
Ow!
Anyway, I got to read what he says. My darling Jean, you will always be my perfect match.
That's right.
With all my lust, Sybil.
Oh, you weren't supposed to read that part.
Oh.
Now put it in your wallet.
Sybil?
Okay.
Can I have a picture for my closet?
She thinks you make a lot of money, Jean, apparently.
The only way I can get this in my wallet, which I happen to have here.
Oh, that's all right. Fold it up. Yes.
Fold it up.
But you have to promise to carry it by your heart.
Carry it by my heart. Okay. I'm going to look lumpy.
That's
but
all right.
Never look lumpy.
That's all right because you're very slim. You always look good.
No okay for you.
Look like.
I mean, if. All right.
Oh,
here
handsome.
We go.
Thumpa, thumpa, thumpa.
You're looking more like Sybil, Gene.
I look do look a little like Sybil. It's about a 38D cup, I say. All right. Here we have Craig Williams and Patrice Weston. Applause, applause, applause. Welcome. Craig, let's find out about you first.
Well, I'm married and I have a little 9-month-old little girl who
yep.
tears the house up, and I'm from a small town in Wisconsin named Cadott, and that's halfway between the equator and North
Pole. Say it again.
Cadott.
Cadott. How do you spell that?
C-A-D-O-T-T.
C-A-D-O. Is that an Indian name?
French Indian.
French Indian. Cadott, Wisconsin. That's
yeah.
right.
Yeah,
Pierre Marquette and all those French cats traveled through there.
Of course they did.
Right. Yeah. All right.
And halfway between the equator and North Pole, you'll find it.
Is that right?
And I'm a dairy farmer, and that's it.
How many cows you got, Craig?
Total about 72.
72. They're all milked by machine?
And what's left, I get by my hand.
You have to do it by hand?
What's left?
Let me see your hands. He has calluses on his hands. Do the cows object to that?
Sometimes.
How do they express their objection?
Very angry.
They do. Swish their tail in your face?
Yes, but...
They do more than that.
Yeah.
I don't want to hear any more about it, Craig. Patrice, let's find out about you, please.
Hi, I'm married to my husband, Steve, for 10
years. You're married to your husband?
Yeah.
She's married to her husband. How about that? We wouldn't have it any other way, Patrice.
I probably should shut up now, huh?
No.
Oh, okay.
Go ahead.
I have a 22-month-old son who started me on my new career of teaching babies to read.
Really?
Yeah.
You don't have a 22-month-old baby who can read.
Yes, I do.
You do? That's a great accomplishment, isn't it? What does your baby read?
Well, I have a system of flashcards that I started when he was 2 months old, and now I have parents in my class who have taught their children. I have a graduating class of over 250 parents whose children read also.
And what is the average age of the children in the class?
They start at 3 months to about 24 months old.
That's really astounding. I'm delighted to hear about that, and congratulations. Great accomplishment. Okay. Now, let's get on to the match game before Patrice starts flashing at us with her cards here. Here on the match game, you'll have three chances to match as many of the stars as you can, if we ever get to it. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner. Go on to challenge our returning champion, Hollywood Squares, chance to win up to $30,000. Craig, you won the toss. You go first.
B, please, Gene.
B it is. Here we go. I'm carrying my heavy wallet over here.
Oh,
here it is. Weird Willie is so weird.
How weird is he?
I'm going to tell you. His car has a bumper sticker that says, "Honk if you love blank." Isn't that crazy? Weird Willie, so weird. Bumper sticker on his car says, "Honk if you love blank." All right, we're ready for you. Weird Willie is so weird, his car has a bumper sticker that says, "Honk if you love blank."
Politicians.
Politicians.
Good answer.
That would be weird.
Oh, I like that answer.
You don't think it's weird to love a politician? No. Okay, Sybil, what do you say?
Well, when I drive in my car, I always notice that when you see weirdos driving around, I think there's only one thing they really would love you to do is to honk if you're in love with them.
Honk if you love weirdos.
Yeah.
Okay,
that's
I like
good.
That.
Yeah. You just like Sybil, Gene.
Who asked you? All right, Anson.
Well, you know, Willie didn't get along with his parents too well, so he didn't get a lot of love, so honk if you love me.
Weird Willie's
a similar
there.
Line.
He says, honk if you love me.
Yeah,
hey,
hey. I saw a bumper sticker the other day that said, "I break for nobody." I didn't like that. But I think that he would say, "Honk if you love accidents."
All right, there's a good answer.
That's weird.
That's a good one.
That's
a good one.
Thank you.
That's a good one. Thank you.
Yeah, Weird Willie would say, "Honk if you love accidents."
Hey,
I think
nice
that's excellent.
Guy.
Anything like that. What do you say, John?
I say because, you know, I've been on the show a long time now, and this is your basic, definitive answer of someone who people don't love. Howard.
Honk if you love Howard Cosell.
Howard. He's your basic
Howard.
That's experience for you.
Right. Jenna Lee.
I like Howard Cosell.
I like him, too.
Oh,
I have
sure.
To admit,
sure, somewhere. Get out of it now. I think that Anson Williams is extremely intelligent, besides being so good-looking, because he had the same answer that I did.
Hey. Honk if you love me.
Who would drive around with a honk if you love me?
He didn't have the same answer as you. You're Jenny
Pretty Girl.
All right, Mr. Fry.
Craig, I wish you had been here a few weeks earlier. As a dairy farmer, there was a question I had about a bull sperm bank that
was memorable.
I'm still trying to figure out. Unfortunately, I don't match. I'm with Sybil on Sybil's track, which is a track you'd like to be on, wouldn't you? I said, weirdos, honk if you like.
Honk if you love weirdos. All right. So, Craig didn't score with that. Let's see if Patrice does anything with this one here. Say, did you hear about the world's most unsanitary doctor? I shall tell you about him. In over 50 years of practice, he's used the same blank on every patient. Very unsanitary. Or it is also correct to say insanitary, doctor.
I'll show you.
All right, ready, Jenna Lee. Patrice.
Yeah.
This world's most unsanitary doctor, in over 50 years of practice, he's used the same blank on every patient.
Thermometer?
Thermometer would be good. There is a wild boar in the first row. Are you the guy who's going, yeah? You?
The blonde.
Who is that? The blonde kid, yes. All right. Sybil. He's used the same blank on every patient.
Well, every time I think of doctors, I don't trust him much, and I only go when I really have to. And I don't mind being needled by a handsome man, but never by doctors, so...
Use the same needle.
Yeah, if he used the same needle,
that would be very unsanitary.
That would be bad.
Whatever she says, that wild boar loves it.
Yeah. Any clubs out there today? What?
Anson Williams fan club.
Any clubs out there today?
No, apparently not.
Yeah.
No.
I'm in trouble then, okay.
No, Gene Woods, is there a homogenous
Dean
group
Millet.
There?
Ellie's Mixers.
Ellie's Mixers.
Ah.
All right. Ellie's Mixers. There we
they
go.
Still need makeup. Look at them.
They didn't
stay with me, girl.
Ellie's right. Mixers. Look at them.
All right,
well,
show and tell.
When I think of doctor, I kind of think of...
Yes,
so, I said knife or scalpel.
He's used the same scalpel or knife on every patient.
Ellie!
Gross.
We're looking for a thermometer. Phil.
Well, I know you are. Unfortunately, you're not going to find it here because I also said scalpel, but I don't know how to spell it. So I tried several different versions. You get the general idea. I'm sorry.
I like scalpel.
Thank you anyway.
Scalpel. He's used the same scalpel on every patient. What do you say?
Ellie's Mixers.
Scalpel. Yeah.
How mixed are they?
Or what do you mix? Yeah.
They're mixed up, I can tell that. Well, I said something that you're going to like. Thermometer! That's one.
Number one.
Okay, Genevieve.
I think the answer's like needles and scalpels. They're dumb answers because every time you go into the doctor's office, you don't have a needle or a scalpel. But what do you always have? Standard, whenever you go to the doctor's.
All right, Genevieve.
Thermometer! Yeah!
Leonard?
Sorry,
I
thought you could use the same thermometer for 50 years if you just clean it off with a little Lavoris.
You spit on it, don't you? Spit on it, wipe it on your...
That's all right, isn't it?
Well,
I thought if you take a tongue depressor...
Okay, so you're ahead at the end of round one, 2-0. Round two coming up right after this.
Toy Streets and Answers are all just a click away. Save 30% on your first order today at Chewy.
Right, here we go to round two. Okay. Now, Patricia, Ed, you have to go first.
I'll go with B.
All right.
What would you do such
Here's
a thing?
Here's what B says. Leonard?
Oh, sit down.
He's visiting.
You're getting your own show, are you? You're doing a little show with them up there?
Sybil had something to tell me, and I had to listen.
Sybil.
I like my men to listen.
Yeah, all right.
Something to say.
You didn't say, what am I chopped liver? Yes.
Would all of you respond to this, please?
What do you want?
Yes, sir.
Larry the Lush said.
Larry the Lush said.
This is right.
10 minutes, here
he
we
loves
go.
This.
I may drink a lot, but my wife adores me. In fact, she worships the ground I blank on.
Could you repeat that question, please? Larry the Lush said, I drink a lot, but my wife adores me. In fact, she worships the ground I blank
on. Don't blank on.
Okay.
Yeah, you matched the previous round, the two of you.
Great.
What shall we do instead?
We're already up here.
This one's right.
There we go. Larry the Lush said, I may drink a lot, but my wife adores me. In fact, she worships the ground I blank on.
Stumble on. No. That's okay.
I think
Thank
what they're
you.
Expecting
right.
is
it's
something
okay.
a little more graphic
yes,
than
nice
that.
Cuba.
The wild boars like it.
Or maybe even fall down. She said stumble, Sybil. What do you say?
Well, I haven't had that much experience, but I imagine...
You don't drink.
No, I don't drink, and I don't have men around me that drink so much, but I know that when you see these films, usually the guys that drink a lot, they're sort of making their way into the house, and then they sort of just get to the bed and pull a blanket down, or they don't even get to the house. So I would think that she would probably worship the ground that
he sleeps
on.
In fact, she worships the ground I sleep on.
He'll never make it into bed if he
drinks a lot. Oh, he passes out, in other words.
He passes out on the ground.
Okay.
The crowd's getting hostile.
The boars have turned.
All right, Anson.
Ellie's Mixer. Better talk fast. I said, if you drink a lot, you pass out.
Pass out. Okay. All right, she worships the ground I pass out on.
Yeah, just a second. Okay, I think I'm ready to say this now. The ground you crawl on.
Down you crawl on. Another good one. All right, we'll come right to you, Leonard.
Right to me. Sorry, Patrice. Pass out.
Pass out.
You've obviously never woken up in the bathroom.
See, you were too gentle, Patrice. Stumble was a little too gentle. Pass out or fall down or any of those would be good. Craig, you ready?
Ready.
Here it is. Ken the cop said, I think that guy used to be a peeping Tom. Hmm. He's reading Playboy magazine through a blank. Everyone plays?
May I hear it one more time, please?
Yes, of course. Ken the cop said.
He just wants to get closer to you, Sybil.
Yes, yeah. I think
that guy used to be a peeping Tom. He's reading Playboy magazine through a blank.
Does it make you nervous when everyone watches like this?
Yes.
Does it? Okay. Here we go. Craig, I think that guy used to be a peeping Tom. He's reading Playboy magazine through a...
window.
Through a window. Okay. Peeping Toms do that. They peep through windows and et cetera, et cetera. What do you say?
I said glass.
Glass. Is that a match? Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
Wait a minute.
He also drinks.
Oh, they did it. Oh, all right. Okay, Anson.
Well, you know, when I'm during my peeping Tom days,
peeping.
I mean, I look through my Playboy.
Yeah.
through a right through a peephole.
A peephole, right. That's one way to do it. That's why they call them peeping Tom.
It's a lot of fun.
It is.
A real peephole, yes. Right. Well, I said that you'd be reading it through a keyhole.
Keyhole. Another good one.
Sorry.
All right. Reading Playboy magazine through
what do you say, real peephole? That's
no.
A show on NBC, isn't it?
That's right.
Yeah, real peephole. One of my favorites. I didn't say any of that. I said a telescope.
Telescope, another good one.
Good answer.
Peeping Tom would use that.
Come on, Jenny. No. We did not do it this time. People.
People. She's looking for window.
Peeping Tom.
All right, Leonard, here we go.
I haven't done it at all. This is not my day. The Novocaine has gone to my brain.
Oh.
Keyhole.
Keyhole.
So sorry.
What she wanted. So we've got a very tight game going here at the end of round two. 2-1 is the score in Patrice's favor. Round three, final round after this.
G. Wentworth.
All right, here we go with the third and final round.
Yeah.
You're still ahead. You have to go first again.
Well, gee, I was so great with B. Let's go with B again.
You want B?
Yeah.
All right. Unlucky Louise said.
Yes.
She said, my lousy luck. This is Louise speaking.
Oh, do that again, Gene.
My lousy luck, she said.
Wonderful.
As soon as I had my face lifted, my blank fell. On your own. I can offer no assistance of any kind.
This is it.
Never happens with the guys, you know.
Patrice, unlucky Louise said, my lousy luck. As soon as I had my face lifted, my blank fell.
Derriere.
Derriere. All right. Okay. There's one possibility. What do you say? You say bazoom.
Well, I was just...
Well, hold it up.
I don't think I spelled it
don't
right.
Don't be ashamed of it. If you've got them, show them.
Yeah, but when it falls, you have to be ashamed of it.
Oh,
right?
I see. All right.
Don't want it to
it's
fall.
It's a bosom.
Anson.
Well, having had the opportunity to sit next to Sybil this week, I've become a chest man.
I see. As soon as I had my face lifted, my chest fell.
I also enjoy a good game of chest, but... excuse me. But I said boobs, and...
All right.
Still
there.
Sorry. Sorry, buddy.
She's looking for buns or derriere or
yeah,
something, bottom or whatever.
Right.
You don't write, you don't
no,
write, and Leonard,
I
we
write.
Come. I, you do write.
I write.
That's what I
and
hear.
And I left.
You're
yes.
wrong.
You left.
And facelifts.
Right.
You want to hear my Marlene Dietrich imitation?
Go.
Having it done again. This is not my chin. It's my kneecap.
However, thank
let's
you
hear
very much.
It. Leonard Fry.
Don't encourage him. And now for my Audie Murphy imitate. No, I got the wrong card.
All right, she had bazooms also.
We all
okay, now, Craig, you're really in a pretty good spot here because all you need is one to tie and two to win. Let's see what happens. Brenda said, my new husband is really well-mannered. When he nibbles on my ear, he uses a blank. My new husband is well met. You don't play. You mentioned a previous round. My new husband's really well-mannered. When he nibbles on my ear, he uses a blank. That's good. Splendid. Yeah, that's okay. That's fine.
Just like that.
Ready, answer. Here we go, Craig. Brenda said my new husband is really well-mannered. When he nibbles on my ear, he uses a blank.
A napkin.
Napkin is one possibility. All right. Would you have said napkin?
Yeah, that's what I was going to write.
He said napkin. He's one to tie and two to win.
I was really going to do that.
You were going to say napkin.
Yeah, but when I nibble, I use a knife and fork.
Knife and fork. That's okay. That's one way to nibble. No, that's not a bad answer. Wait a minute. There is usually more than one good answer, and that happens to be one of the good ones.
Yeah. It's not the best answer because, really, you should just use a fork, you see.
Oh, a fork alone.
Yeah, but he saw me write it, and so he added knife to the bowl. That's fine. Thank you.
All right. John, we come to you. When he nibbles on my ear, he uses a...
Well, it's really not the best answer because the best answer, obviously, is napkin.
Hey. At least according to Craig.
Tie score is what we have.
The game moves along.
I goofed.
Wait a minute.
No,
hold on. The judges might consider that to be a napkin.
They're deciding.
Do they?
Oh.
No.
What is it?
They don't?
No.
They do not.
Well, I thought you have a tissue right there. You don't always have a napkin right there, you know?
Right.
Napkin. I don't even know you.
That's it, Jenny.
Yeah.
Give them what for. Now, Leonard, at this moment we have a tie. You can untie it, or you can cause us to go to a tiebreaker. The pressure is all on you, and poor Leonard has all his pressure on him with a
novocaine finger.
Yes.
Come on,
Marlena, you can do it.
When he nibbles on my ear, he uses a knife.
In a minute. Patrice, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
I really think you've got something remarkable going in your school of teaching infants to read, and I congratulate you for that. I hope the gifts we send your way from Match Game will be useful to you. Thank you, Patrice Fletcher. All right. Now, time now to switch. Would you join me over here, Craig? Here comes the rest of our set. To enable us to bring in three more stars, who'll be making their entrance here in a moment or so. I'm going to switch places with John Bauman, who'll be hosting Hollywood Squares. We've got lots more excitement coming your way. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive the Silver Reed Penman, fully electronic, compact, daisy wheel typewriter, practical enough for the home, durable enough for the office, furnished by Silver Reed. And now, it's time for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Square, our with from real people, Mark Russell. From another world, Mary Paige Keller. McCormick. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bauman.
Okay, and we will be right back. You come back too.
This is...
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
Second half of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
And once again, we say hello to Craig Williams, who has survived the Match Game competition and is now ready to take on our defending champion in Hollywood Squares. We also are going to welcome three new celebrities, Pat McCormick, Mary Paige Keller, and Mark Russell. Mary.
Yes.
Mary Paige Keller, you are on the show Another World, which happens to be our lead-in. And is
Indeed.
Doing very well, and is a highly watched show here on NBC. How's everything going? Tell us a little bit about
Fine.
What's new on the show.
I have an illegitimate child and an ex-lover and a... ex-fiancé, but
like to see us?
I'm just fine, thank you. Yeah. Everything's going well.
So just an illegitimate child and an ex-lover.
Yes. And an ex-fiancé.
Yes.
And,
oh. Right. Well, you're surrounded by them here in the Hollywood.
It's one of those soaps that
okay,
so
gay.
One
Craig.
Of those soaps is so sexy, the announcer got pregnant the other day.
All right, we got our own soap opera going here. It's called Try to Beat the Defending Champion in Hollywood Squares. Here we go. And this has turned into quite a saga for you. This is a long-running soap opera for you, Victoria Narbutis. You are returning with $34,950. And a very successful run, and I'm sure in your book, very, very highly rated.
Yes.
Now that you have this amount of money, tell us what you think you might do with it. You're a newlywed. You've only been married for 3 weeks. You must have lots of plans.
Oh, I've always wanted to have something to put down to get a house, so now we have enough money to put down to get a house.
Terrific. Now you don't have to sell your husband. You can just do it here from Hollywood Square. Okay, now we're going to play this game, and we're going to play it until you hear the Time's Up bell. Now, whoever is ahead at that point, as you probably know, is our winner and goes on to play the Super Match for up to $30,000, which you have won once. Our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square that is captured. Our champion always gets to start. That is Victoria. Pick a square, and let's go.
Anson, please.
Anson Williams.
Yo.
What has more calories? The hot dog or the bun?
The hot dog or the bun? Well, you know, they take, all sorts of different meats to make that hot dog, and it's more protein. It's not really a lot of calories. And in the bun, there's a lot of sugar, a lot of butter. So it's definitely the bun.
He says the bun has more calories than the hot dog. Agree or disagree for the first square, Victoria?
I disagree.
The hot dog has more calories than the bun. That shows why you've been on 5 days in a row. You got the square and $25. Okay, Craig Williams, she was tough. You are playing O. Pick a star.
Leonard, please.
Leonard Fry.
Thank you. A whispered yay.
Yay!
They were hoping for a Marlena, Leonard. Which lasts longer, your average fan belt or your average garter belt?
Come on, Leonard.
Which lasts longer, garter belt or a fan belt?
Show him your garter belt, Leonard.
I'll show you my garter belt.
He has a fan belt holding his garter.
Come here, Leonard. I'll tell you a little secret again.
Tell me.
Fan belt or a garter belt?
Yes. No, are you there?
The
I'm there.
Come in,
yes,
Leonard.
I'm there. I feel that unequivocally, as I say with all this trepidation on my face, a garter belt.
He says the average garter belt lasts longer than the average fan belt. Agree or disagree, Craig?
I agree.
The average fan belt lasts longer than the average garter belt. You should have disagreed with Leonard, and an X
you
goes
don't know
up there.
Garter belts, Leonard.
The average fan belt lasts a year and a half, but a garter belt only lasts, believe it or not, 3 months on the average.
Says who?
Not a goodbye.
Who says?
We have authorities.
Who
we have people who know. After the commercial, I may
You're
be able
not
to
used
tell
to garter belts, are you?
Victoria Narbutis, you have two X's up there in a row. Pick a star for me.
Pat, please.
Pat McCormick, and this would be to win the first game. Pat, according to Modern Bride magazine, who should pay for the groom's medical examination? The bride or the groom?
Give me a break.
Who sent me a...
Let's see. Below the waist? No, I have no idea. Bride or the groom? Oh. No, I happen to know that because of Emily Post... I was going to do a show with her. I'm pretty sure. I know the answer, but I'm trying to see the.
Would you care to tell us?
The groom.
Yeah, the groom. The groom should pay for his own medical examination for the game. Agree or disagree, Victoria?
I agree.
The groom should pay for his own medical examination. The rest agree. You got the square. You win the first game. Boy, you are on a roll, 175. Not us so far, Craig, but there's plenty of time. We're going to be back to play a $200 game after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
I was on.
Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Okay, our next game is worth $200, $25 for every square that is captured. The last game was won by Victoria. That means that, Craig, you get to start this one. Pick a star.
Anson, please.
Wait your turn, Victoria.
Craig, you're a typical man. I mean, Anson, you're a typical man.
That's
wait
a hard
minute.
Question.
I'm a typical man? Okay.
According to this, imagine. You dream that you give a woman a bag of pistachios. According to the book, what your dreams mean. Are you sexually attracted to this woman, or do you think she's nuts?
I'm just a regular guy and I have a dream, and I pretend I'm giving a girl a bag of pistachio nuts, and do I think that's, is that a sexual thing or is she nuts?
Right.
Well, hey, I have to tell you, to open a pistachio nut and eat it and all that with, you know, all that stuff you have to do, it's very sensual. So definitely it's sexual.
He says you're sexually attracted to that woman. You give the pistachios, agree or disagree for the first square in this game, Craig.
Have to agree.
You're sexually attracted to her. You have to agree and you're right to agree. You get the first square and you get
buy those pistachios.
There. Okay, 1-0 for him. You're playing X, Victoria. Where would you like to put an X?
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Gene is ready.
Which one of these people was once a game show host? Was it Ronald Reagan or Walter Cronkite?
Walter Cronkite, I think he worked in the West Coast somewhere early in his career, and conceivably, he might have done that.
He says Walter Cronkite was once a game show host. Agree or disagree, Victoria?
I agree.
Walter Cronkite it was. Nice. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get the square. In 1954, Walter Cronkite hosted a show called It's News to Me.
Dialing for bowlers.
Okay, Craig, your move with an O.
Well, Reagan had one. It was called What's My Foreign Policy?
It's still running, isn't
yes.
it? Yeah. Okay, Craig, pick a star.
Phil, please.
Phil Proctor. Thank you.
Yes, yes, I'm here. I'm waiting.
You gave your girlfriend the world's hardest Christmas present.
Yes.
What did you give her?
How did you find out about this? The world... Go ahead.
That was the whole question.
That's it? Well, I gave her the... Say it again. I don't want to embarrass
The world's hardest Christmas present. What was it?
Hardest?
Mm-hmm.
Christmas present? What did I give her?
Mm-hmm.
That's the question?
Does he get a choice?
Your agent's
no choices or anything. I just have
choice?
To...
That's
the
it,
The hardest
Phil.
Christmas present.
That's
What's
all she
the
wrote.
Hardest? Titanium? Something heavy. Hard.
Chocolate
iron,
chip titanium.
Iron.
It's your agent's heart.
Oh, this is so embarrassing. Why are you pointing to your chest?
I wasn't.
Well, are
get
you...
Close.
Oh, diamonds.
Okay. He says diamonds would be the world's hardest Christmas present. Agree or disagree, Craig?
I have to agree.
A diamond it is.
Whoa!
Right to agree. Okay. You get the square. That means he's got two O's in a row up here, Victoria. You are playing X. Woo! Pick a star.
Sybil to block, please.
Right. You missed this one. The game belongs to Craig Williams. Sybil Danning, which came first? The Playboy centerfold? Or the Polaroid snapshot?
Good question for you, Sybil.
Yes, Sybil.
Didn't they
go
use
ahead.
Polaroids in Playboy first? It looks to me like they use the Polaroids in Playboy first.
That's not the question.
And, yeah, but I'm
okay, all right.
You know, I've never seen Playboy, so I'm trying to think now.
I know a mean person.
Think fast, Sybil.
I would say, knowing well,
I know
these technical
a mean
things
person.
Work, yes. No, I know. I would say the Playboy centerfold.
She says the Playboy centerfold came before the Polaroid snapshot. To block, Victoria, agree or disagree?
I disagree.
The Polaroid snapshot came before the Playboy centerfold. You were right to disagree, and you get to square and you do block. We get to complete our $200 game right after this. You get to come back and watch it.
It's starting at 2 on Buzzer.
Okay, 225 for Victoria and 50 so far for Craig. But we are in the middle of a game that is pivotal because it's worth $200. It is your move, Craig. You're playing O, pick a star.
Pat the block, please.
Mm-hmm. You missed this one. Victoria gets a big lead. Pat McCormick, your bleached blonde hair turned green in the swimming pool.
Huh.
You've got a date in a few hours. Now, according to household hints expert Mary Ellen, what will fix it? A solution of aspirin or liquid fish fertilizer?
Oh. His date also has green hair, so it doesn't...
Took it in my water bed, which my wife declared the Dead Sea. I'd say the fish fertilizer, having been a lot of things have turned green on me. I had to go to Lourdes to get a hangover cure the other day.
Craig, he says that fish fertilizer will fix that green hair. Agree or disagree to block?
I'll have to disagree.
A solution of aspirin, it is. You were right to disagree, and you get the square, and you do block. Woo. Okay, and once again, it's a seesaw battle back and forth. That changes the complexion of things. Victoria, you're playing X. Where would you like to move?
Jenny Lee, please.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Victoria.
Okay. You want to move to Jenny Lee, even though you had an opportunity to block. Okay, Jenny Lee Harrison. How many toes does a Barbie doll have? 10 or none?
Well, last time I braided them.
You love this question, don't you?
Yes, I do.
You know what? I think none. I don't think that, because they're always covered up. I don't think that they would take the time to, put on all those little toes and stuff. It's a lot of plastic, a lot of things that, those people in the factories have to work on. Mm-hmm. Moving right along, none.
So they just don't bother with the toes, she says. Yeah. No toes on a Barbie doll. Agree or disagree, Victoria?
I think, it's just the foot. It was just the foot, and they slide in.
She's thinking now, generally. Cool it. Okay, she says no toes on the Barbie doll. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
There are 10 toes on the Barbie doll. You're right to disagree. And you get that square. They're all okay. Now, she chose not to block. The bell means time is up. $250. She is saved by the bell, possibly. Victoria Narbonis once again. 5 days in a row, she's done it. Now, as you can see, she's a veteran of this game. She doesn't wait. She just goes over there. She wants to give Gene Rayburn a little kiss and a little hug and get ready to play the Super Match. Greg, you're still here with me. We have to say goodbye to you. It was really a very close game. You have $75, but it was much closer than that, as we all know. And you have our thanks for playing Match Game Hollywood Squares. Attaboy. Okay, Gene Rayburn, take it away.
Here we go, John. Our congratulations, Victoria. We'll be back with her and our 9 celebrities, and we'll see how much more money she'll win right after this.
Answer? Armor.com. Order now.
Now, here to play the Super Match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gene Wood. All right. I want to point out that the rules state that the maximum number of days one can appear in this position for the Supermatch is 5 days. This is Victoria's 5th day, and we wish her well and hope she wins another $30,000. Here we go. We polled the recent studio audience and write down your best answer to this. Blank agent. Remember, we've got $1,000 for the top one, $500 for the second most popular, and $250 for the third. Now, which stars would you like to call upon for a little assist here?
John, please.
Secret agent.
Secret agent is one.
Anson, please.
Talent.
Talent agent, two.
What?
Mary, please.
You stole my two. I have theatrical agent.
Theatrical agent, talent agent, and secret agent are the three they've given you. Now you have to make a decision of choosing one of those or thinking up one of your own.
Secret agent.
Yeah. You want to go for secret agent? All right. Let's see if it's up there. And if so, where? Apparently, you think it's a correct decision, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's look for secret agent. May we see the $250 response? Talent agent is up there. We have that. All right. The $500 response says travel agent. Hey, that's not a bad one. Travel agent, a good one. Last chance for secret agent. Here we go. Slide it, Greg.
Yeah!
All right, Victoria. Now, you got the $1,000. It's time now to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And remember, the star you choose will reveal that hidden number, a 10, a 20, or a 30. We'll multiply that number by the $1,000, which is now yours. Time to make your pick.
I hate to be repetitious, but John, please.
You think the big 3-0 is going to be there for the second day in a row?
Well, I just like John.
All right.
Good luck, John. You just got married, Victoria.
Is something going on that we should know about, John?
They both have the same rash.
They both have the what?
Same rash.
All right.
They don't have the same nose, that's for sure.
Now, would you grab the tab there and give it a whirl, and let's see what the hidden number is.
Okay.
Go. A 10. All right, that means you're playing for $10,000. All right.
You'll have over $45,000 if you collect this one. Good luck to you. This is it. Just square around and face me a little more. All right. Blank opener. Or blank opener. No help from the audience, please. If we hear an answer, we got to start all over again. All right. John is ready. It's up to you to match him and collect that $10,000. How do you do that?
Can opener.
Can opener is what she said. Okay, John, here we go. The moment of truth for the big money, $10,000. She says can opener will match you.
Well, you know, before she came on this show, Victoria probably was saying to herself, I wonder if it's really possible to be on this show for 5 days in a row. Can someone do that and win a lot of money? And the answer is yes, she can.
$46,200. $46,200. Another 10. Okay, friends, we'll be back right after this.
It's so easy to
number on your screen.
Okay, now, hold it. Before I tell you who this fellow is, let's reveal the big 3-0 here. Who's got the big 3-0?
Voulez-vous, Mary!
Mary had it. I'll tell you who this fellow is now. There's been so much hugging and kissing going on between Victoria and John, I figured I better bring Victoria's husband down here to chaperone this whole thing. How do you feel?
Great.
What are you going to do with the money?
We're going to put a down payment home in a home.
That's wonderful.
That's terrific. The Match Game Hollywood Squares Dream House Hour.
Right. Thank you all. Gene Rayburn here inviting you to join us next time.
And John Babin saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares.
A member of our studio audience will receive Gibson's Variable Speed Washmaster Automatic Washer, designed to save time and energy, plus matching automatic dryer with vacuum dry system for energy efficient drying power, furnished by Gibson. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.